Standing by. All personnel be aware, car leaving. Thank you.
you join us in Portimao as we prepare for what will undoubtedly be a magnificent day of racing. It's time, of course, for the Portuguese Grand Prix. So Portimao features 15 turns over the course of its 2.9-mile length. 9 are right-handers, 6 are to the left, and this is a track with a lot of uphill action, which only accentuates the importance of getting those exits right, especially at turn 4, where a good line can present opportunities to pass on the way into turn 5. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are 3 main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The Finn starts from pole position, edging out Sergio Perez, who lines up P2. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Norris, Ricciardo, Charles Leclerc and Hamilton, Fernando Alonso, Sainz, Gasly and Yuki Tsunoda, Stroll, Raikkonen, George Russell and Vettel, Ocon. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Mick Schumacher, Nicholas Latifi and Nikita Mazepin, Giovinazzi. They've taken a grid penalty and Max Verstappen completes the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Everything looks good on the power unit cycle, so let's concentrate on bringing tyres and brakes up to temperature. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. All right, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
His team pulled out a fantastic performance today. They should be proud. Talk to me, Ant. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team. And they certainly deserve it. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
Often my go-to would be a driver who's managed to pull off an especially impressive feat during the race. However, in this instance, I was more impressed by Max Verstappen's solid, clean driving throughout the event.
Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.